Hello.
Hi.
Really good to see you.
Thank you. This is fun.
Looking so fantastic as well.
Thank you very much.
So you're back in the latest Iron Man movie.
Yes.
Now, this is the fourth time that you've played Pepper Potts.
This is the fourth time I've played Pepper Potts.
What is it about the character that, you know, just keeps bringing you back?
It's really Robert and his, you know, he likes me around, so he keeps asking me to come back and join him, so I do.
I can see a lot of Robert in Tony Stark, and I'm guessing that obviously Pepper Potts is somebody who can control Tony. I imagine you're actually somebody who can control Robert.
I'm pretty good at controlling Robert. I put my sort of matron hat on and knock him down a few pegs, correct his behavior. But no, he's great. He's such a good guy.
So at the end credits, it does say Tony Stark will return.
Does it?
A bit like Bond, James Bond will return.
Oh.
So does that mean that you're going to be back as well?
You know, so far, wherever Iron Man has shown up, Pepper has shown up as well. So we'll see. I would like to if I got to do more of this kind of action stuff, especially.
I know you're really into your cooking as well. Have you ever cooked for anyone on set?
You know what? Actually, when I was making this movie, I was testing a lot of recipes in the trailer at lunch and stuff like that. So I cook. Yeah, there are people coming in and having tastes of this and that.
I want your brownies.
Thank you.
I really want. Next time you come and do a big interview with Magic,
okay.
We're going to pick all your loads and loads of songs.
I'll bring in a tray of brownies. You'll be very happy.
It's on camera as well, by the way,
yes.
So she can't go back on that. Listen, it is nearly time to finish up. Just a flying visit, but we need to get one of your song choices on.
Okay.
What would you like to pick for us?
Do I get to pick a Rick Astley song?
You can pick
Does
a Rick
Does everyone pick a Rick Astley song who comes
Not
up?
Not everyone.
I would either have to pick Rick Astley or Coldplay, wouldn't I? Can you do a mashup?
Probably.
Okay. If you could, I want a Coldplay Rick Astley mashup. That's what I want.
Oh, you've just set somebody a target that they're going to have to fulfill by Sunday. Love it. Fantastic. Fantastic movie. It's called Iron Man 3.
Yeah.
And you're playing the Mandarin, who is the baddie.
Mm-hmm.
We can see a picture of you behind you.
It's great, isn't it?
It's just...
This guy looming over my shoulder, it's scary. He's a scary guy.
He's so sinister.
Yeah.
Can I ask you what you think the appeal of Iron Man in particular is, because all of these superhero films have done very well, but Iron Man seems to have done the best out of all of them.
You know, certainly as an action film, it's the top of the genre as an action film. The action sequences are extraordinary, but then what the producers and writers and directors have done is they've interspersed the violent, extraordinary action scenes with scenes of great tenderness, love, comradeship, loss, grief, anger, they're all so vulnerable to being pulled and pushed by their human emotions. So what's inside the iron suit is something that everyone in the audience can relate to. Oh, I have self-doubt. Oh, I love. Oh, I just lost. Oh, I've found again. So it's very sophisticated action movie that doesn't dumb anybody in the audience down.
Loads and loads of explosions and stuff blowing up and all that. How much of that do you see when you're on
None
set?
Of it. None of it.
At all?
I mean, really, it's a green screen world, and all of that stuff gets put in later, and you're hoping that they've told you actually what it is so that your reactions match what's going on around you.
Yeah, you got 17 Iron Men flying around you. Go.
Yeah, pretty much, you know, pretty much. What's happening over here, what's happening over there, you don't really know. So you really have to trust the team, and you get to see stuff in previs, and we get to see mock-ups, but it's only until after it's all put together that we really see what's happening.
Gwyneth Paltrow plays Pepper Potts again. Mm-hmm. It's the fourth time she's played it now.
It'd be strange if she played Rhodey.
Weird, wouldn't it?
It'd be weird.
But she does get to wear the suit.
Yeah.
Did you give her any tips at all?
I didn't. I saw Gwyneth, you know, before we filmed it and here. I didn't see her at all in the set. No, actually, one scene I got to see her. But you know, it's amazing. We're in these movies with these other actors. Rebecca and I were never in a scene together. You know, Guy and I were in one scene together. So, you know, it's great that they're in the movie, but I've never saw them on the set.
Well, Gwyneth was saying that she was cooking for everyone on set. She was doing her new recipes in the trailer. Yeah.
Never cooked for me.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's something to look forward to.
Yeah, I'm over her.
Well, listen, I can't wait for Iron Man 4, and I hope you end up in the Avengers as well.
Me too. Thank you.
Just such a great franchise, if you like. But this is by far the best of the lot. It's brilliant.
Thank you. Appreciate it.